Hey battles, are you curious about hair, makeup, tattoos, jewelry, cosmetics, and pretty much anything that has to do with your appearance while in uniform? Well, today I'm going to be answering a few questions and hopefully one of them are yours. Before we get into the video, if I don't answer your question or you feel some of my information is incorrect, please let me know down below in the comments, or you can go ahead and message me on my Instagram at @_AndreaSiobhan and let's get to it. So I do have the regulation right here for the Army because again, I am in the Army. So all of this information that I'm giving is pertaining to the Army. So I can't take much credit for something that the Army has already laid out. I'm just the narrator. So you can read this stuff on your own under AR-670-1, but I'm just gonna go ahead and reiterate for my ladies who still have questions about weave and acrylics and dreads and nail polish and things of that nature. So starting with hair, according to AR-670-1, a female's hair can be no shorter than 1/4 of an inch unless you have a medical reason, meaning if you have like alopecia or something like that, or for whatever reason you have to have your hair cut shorter than 1/4 of an inch. So yes, you can wear your hair really short, you just can't be skin, like you just can't have a completely bald head. And you can also have your hair as long as you want, given bulk isn't an issue. So you can have hair all the way down to your ankles if you want to, but as long as you can get it up and have it in a small enough bun, you should be okay. Now, if your hair is over 1/4 of an inch, but it's still too short to go into a ponytail, kind of like a fro ordeal, you can wear that, but it cannot protrude more than 1 inch from your scalp. Now, if you have medium length hair, that can be worn down. And according to the Army, medium length hair is anything that protrudes more than 1 inch from the scalp, but it doesn't go past the lower edge of your collar. If you do have the medium hair and you decide to wear your hair down, just keep in mind it has to be symmetrical. It can be asymmetrical, so you can have it like really short in the back and then have it dramatically get longer in the front. You can have this side clear up here and then it swoops down and get longer over here. It has to be one length. And if you have long hair, which is defined by the Army as hair that extends past the lower edge of your collar, then of course you have to wear that up in a bun. Keep in mind with your hair, it has to be within a natural appearance and you can't have hair hanging all in your face. So let's say you do have that medium length hair and you wear your hair down, it has to be out of your face. It can't be going over your eyebrows and things like that. And it also has to be neat in appearance. For those of you wanted to know more about braids, locks, cornrows, dreads, yes, obviously you can wear them now. So for each of the braids, cornrows, twists, locks, they have to be within uniform dimensions. So they have to be around the same size or at least look like they're the same size, and they can't be bigger than 1/2 inch, and they just have to be neat and professional in appearance. This regulation is so open to interpretation, it's crazy, but okay. Now keep in mind, if you are getting your braids and your dreads and stuff like that, make sure if you get them long that they can fit in a nice, professional, small looking bun. And if they are not long enough where they can fit in the bun, you still have to keep in mind that they cannot go past the lower edge of your collar and also cannot exceed 3.5 inches from your scalp. Now, as far as weave go, we all know by now that yes, it is authorized. Wigs are authorized, extensions and things like that are authorized. And honestly, the only thing that the regulation really says about weave is it needs to be neat in appearance. It has to look like your natural hair. It has to be within the same appearance of your natural hair, keeping in mind the standards for the lengths and things like that. And honestly, there's nothing that really goes into wearing weave. But I do wanna add, do not be that person that's wearing like your lace front or the person that's wearing your weave and it's just all jacked up. You got your lace flying up, you got your tracks hanging out. Just don't be that person, because I have seen some jacked up weave. Now, I don't get my hair done because honestly, I don't need to. I don't really like to. Last time I got my hair done, it got completely destroyed. I digress. I see people every day with horrible, horrible, horrible weave. To the point, I've actually seen a girl who pulled her weave back into, actually, I think it was a wig, because she pulled it back into a ponytail and like the ear parts was folded back as well, where you were able to see like all the lace. It's just, don't be that person. Now for PT, you are authorized to wear a loose ponytail, but you are only authorized to wear a loose or a hanging ponytail when you are actively participating in PT or physical training, when you are actively exercising. So if you stop off anywhere else, so if you go to sick call, if you go to the defects, if you go to the commissary, if you go anywhere and you are not actively exercising, your hair is to be put into a bun according to the regulation. Also, when you are MPTs, you're not allowed to have a top bun like this. Your hair shouldn't be sitting on the top of your head like that. It is not authorized. Just make sure when you do have that ponytail, it's down in the back of your head in a actual ponytail. And if you stop off and you are no longer doing PT, just put it up in a bun. So let's move on to cosmetics. So obviously, men cannot wear makeup, of course, but the regulation says females can wear makeup in all uniforms. Given that it is modestly applied, it is conservative, and it complements your skin tone and the uniform. Again, so open for interpretation, because what is conservative and complements their skin tone and uniform can be completely different if you ask 50 different people. I don't know, maybe. Now, permanent makeup is also authorized as long as it is performed by a licensed professional and it is still within the regulation standards. But even though they are so freaking cute, eyelash extensions are not authorized. I think you can wear them in the Air Force, but you cannot wear them over here in the Army. Sorry. I see a lot of people wearing eyelash extensions and they look really good and no one ever says anything to them. So I think it just goes back to, if you look good and everything looks professional and you look put together, nobody's really gonna say anything to you. So if you're not walking around with those 20 inch eyelashes on and you're walking around with some Ruby Woo lipstick or whatever I got on from Tarte, nobody's gonna say anything to you. So for nails, the regulation says your nails will be needs cleaned and trimmed, and they will not exceed 1/4 an inch from the tip of your finger. Clear nail polish is the only color authorized, or the only kind of polish, because clear isn't a color. As of right now, clear nail polish is the only authorized nail polish you can have in uniform right now. You can also have acrylics as long as they are within the length standards of 1/4 of an inch past your fingertip. Now I do see people, and I get it as well, it's like, it's kind of like a clear, but it has more of like a natural like pink tint to the clear nail polish at the nail shops, I guess. And I see people get away with that perfectly fine, because honestly, I feel like it looks way neater and way cuter than just a clear plain nail polish. I don't have my nails done right now because I'm still healing. I actually broke this entire nail off because I went to BLC with my nails done and I flipped the tire and this little puppy came. It was so painful. But yeah, so I'm still healing my nails and I will be getting them done soon because I want my nails done. But anyway, those natural colors, like the one I like to get is like, what is it called? It's like seafoam pink or seashell pink, bubble bath, those really soft, soft pink, neutral looking colors. So yes, again, the only authorized color is the clears. I'm gonna call them clears because the pinks I was mentioning, they're kind of clear. They just have that natural skin pink look to it. So yeah, so that means no fluorescents, no blues and greens and bright reds and purples, and just no. Okay, the rule of thumb here is we don't want people to look at us twice. Okay, no one should have to double take and guess and try to figure out if something is within regulation or not. You should just be neutral. So the other thing I get a bunch of questions about are tattoos. And honestly, when you read the regulation, from what I can tell, the only unauthorized places for tattoos is the neck up and the wrists up. You are also authorized to have one finger on each hand tattooed in this area here. So I can have a tattoo here and I could have a tattoo here, and that would be my one tattoo on one finger. So you can't have it here. It can only be one, like either here or here. It can't be clear up here. It can't be somewhere up here. It can't be something crazy. It can't be like clear in here. It has to be here, right there. Other than that, you can have a tattoo pretty much anywhere you want, but you have to make sure it is not an indecent tattoo. So if it's anything that's racist, sexist, extremist, if it's vulgar, demeaning to the army, that's a no. You can't have those. And you can't lie about them either, because what's gonna happen is your recruiters are gonna give you a piece of paper. They're gonna tell you to document all of your tattoos. They're going to wanna see all of those tattoos. And then when you get to METS, what's gonna happen is they're gonna have you stripped, and they're gonna look at you, and they're going to see all of your tattoos. And if they see that you lied about one and it may not be acceptable, you could definitely ruin your chances of being able to join the army. Your best bet is to show the tattoos that you may have in question to your recruiters, because only they would know if it is waivable or not. And if you do have a tattoo that cannot be waived, be prepared to either have it removed or covered up if you really want to get into the army. I guess that depends on you then at that point. Oh, and one more thing on tattoos. Tattoo makeup is not authorized either. So that makeup that people use to cover up certain tattoos, no, you can't use it. And don't use it, because you'll get figured out. It'll get figured out. If you show up to basic or your duty station with tattoos in areas they shouldn't be, or tattoos that is very indecent and somebody sees it, it's just gonna be even worse. So just don't do that. Now, the only other thing I wanted to mention is jewelry. I know the Air Force, they are allowed to wear earrings when they're in their uniforms, but here in the Army, we don't get to do that. We don't get to do fun things like that. But in our dress uniforms, we get to wear earrings, and they just have to be either gold, the pearl, like that pearl color. They can be a small little diamond. I actually wear these because they're still really small and no one says anything to me, because they're gold with like little diamonds in them, and they're super cute. And they're still small enough where they look nice and modest and professional. Of course, you can wear a watch, an identification bracelet. You can wear one ring for one finger on each hand, so you can do that. You can wear a religious pendant, but overall you really can't do too much in uniform. Hence, no, you cannot have tongue rings. No, you cannot wear a tongue ring in uniform. You can't have your tongue pierced, even that little clear thing. You can see that and someone may say something to you. Having your nose pierced, your eyebrows pierced, your lip pierced, just no. I mean, I have my lip pierced, you can still see my hole right here, but I had my lip pierced years ago. I've taken this piercing out years ago and I still have a hole there, and I still have people asking me from time to time, like, Starks, do you have your lip pierced? Is your lip pierced? And I say, no, sir, or no, sorry, my lip isn't pierced. Well, there's a hole there. Yeah, because it won't close for whatever reason. So just don't get any of those crazy piercings so people won't say anything to you. Other than that, battlebaes, that is all I have. The AR-670-1 wear an appearance of your uniform and insignia here in the Army. If you have any more questions, please leave them down below. Do not forget, I read every last question, good or bad. If I didn't answer your question, or if I didn't hit on something that you were curious about, leave that down below as well, because I can maybe address that at a later time, or I'll address you right there in the comments. Let's go ahead and have a discussion, because I also wanted to ask for my battlebaes who are in the Army and you do like to dabble in your makeup and have a nice beat every now and then. Do you get treated differently? Do people say anything to you? Do you feel uncomfortable? Or do people embrace the fact that you want to express yourself with this beautiful stuff called makeup? I have different things from different people. I have battlebaes who say that they just completely stopped wearing makeup altogether because it was such a big issue. And honestly, I was kind of in that same boat. And I have people that say that they never have an issue at all because they just are around adults, obviously. So go ahead and let me know in the comments, how do you feel about being able to wear makeup when you are in uniform? All right, see you later. Bye.
trying to make y'all comfortable. For the record, you ain't trying to grow, then it's done for you. For the record, lab on me going all the way. For the record, ain't trying to link, no time to waste. For the record, for the record, for the record.